is my mind of stone? Tear me to pieces, skin and bone. Hello, welcome home.
All right, welcome back, guys. We're here at Santiago Sports. Like I said, last year, 2020, we're gonna be doing another shop tour video. So as you can see, nothing's really changed to the outside. Still looks fucking beautiful, but we're gonna head on in. We got a lot of new stuff going on, a lot of new sections, stuff like that. So let's go. All right, so you walk in, it hits you. You're like, holy fuck, there's a lot of shit in here. Got fan zone sign right there, straight from Modell's. Modell's went out of business, but we're in business, so you know, works out. We got the checkout counter, you see that sign right away. You walk in, straight ahead, you see the big Santiago Sports logo right on the wall. Then you look to the right, we still have the racks of clothing, but what we do have that we didn't have in last video is we have a hat rack over here. We have another rack on the wall with like some graphic socks and whatnot. To the left of us, we changed it up a lot. So, you walk in right to the left, you got Santiago Sports merch. Of course, these are fucking sick. Independent trading company. These are made of cotton and they're machine washable. They're beautiful, tie-dye. We have some custom vintage dead stock sweaters that we put our logo on. This is a Jersey's one from the 90s. We got some Hanes, Fruit of the Loom, Mickey Mouse tags. Of course, we got the Santiago Sports tie-dye tees, only $20 in store. Of course, everyone needs a regular black logo shirt, jumbo logo right on your chest. More hoodies. Of course, we got the fanny packs over here. And then we have some of our vintage apparel right on display right away. We added some brand new racks. We got the $10 racks right here. So anything on here is $10 each. That's steel. We have some of the higher end clothing right here. We have beautiful, I'm not sure if it's one of a kind or not, but a beautiful Mickey Mouse denim jacket. It's bedazzled, it's all stitched, that's beautiful. So we still have the Gatorade rack, one of my favorite pickups before we even open. Gatorade rack is full of Funko Pops. We got a nice little Prince right there, little red Corvette, love him. It's winter now, it's not summer, so we moved some of our dead stock New York graphic tees up here, still have a lot of great ones left. And then we have the winter jackets down here, so let's pull some out. Which one do I like the most? Let's go to Old Denver Broncos. Old Denver Broncos starter satin jacket, $100. It's almost brand new. So we have a lot of winter jackets in stock, so you know, get your warm on. Like I said before, we have the socks over here, a little truffle shuffle, Superman. A lot of this is the football section for all the hats, snapbacks, and whatnot. And then we have jerseys right here. Let me show a really nice one. 2001 All-Star Game American League Derek Jeter jersey. Stitched, authentic. Beautiful piece right there. I mean, look at that. Jeter's overrated, but that's besides the fact. He sells here, so gotta have some Jeter. Have another rack right here. I said some nicer sweaters and whatnot. I'm a big sweater guy, so some of these pay me to sell because I would wear them. We have a basketball jersey rack right here, full of, I mean, some beautiful, beautiful champion jerseys. Let's see. Here's a fucking awesome one. Bryant Reeves, Big Country. Look at that, old Grizzlies logo, Reese on the back, and I want to show one more. Everybody want to pass that shit like Stockton. So here's an old Stockton Jazz logo right there at the Rocky Mountains. It's a beautiful one. So we have tons of champion jerseys in stock. As you're walking in and you look more to your left after the clothing, and in case you want to go right, but we're looking left right now. We have comics. So comics are a new addition to the shop. Like I said, my dad sells things here as well. Love my dad. So we got dollar boxes of comics. We got dollar packs. If you're into Power Rangers, Spider-Man, even some old 90s football. Just stuff that you can open up with your kids, or if you want to open it up for fun, some nostalgia. We have a $10 case, 3 for $25. We have another rack of clothing. Over here, some nicer stuff as well as some wrestling tees and whatnot. So like, here we go. Here's an authentic Vince Carter, Raptors, Deadstock, Adidas. A lot of the wrestling shirts right here. Let's see, this one's kind of fitting. Bushwhack, Iraq. What else do we got? Here's a fucking sick one. Barely ever see this. Trial of the Century OJ Simpson shirt. Absolutely beautiful. And then I'll show one more. An authentic Mitchell & Ness 1996 All-Star Game Michael Jordan jersey. This one is classic. And this is my guy Turk from Tarzan, if you know who that is. All right, so now we're in the front left corner. The other side of that rack is also full of clothing. Here's a sick Kobe Bryant jersey right there. It's a portrait jersey made by Majestic. These do not pop up often, so that's very sick. More basketball over here. We got rid of those bulky shelf things. If you've ever been in here before, I hated them. I got them because I thought they'd be useful, but the more and more stuff you put in here, the more and more cluttered it got, and I wanted to free up some space. Still a little tight in here, but we'll change that one day. So we got some more wrestlers right here. We got the $10 each, 3 for $25 section. Some more socks, Harry Potter, some gloves, Texan gloves, Rangers suck, Yankees suck, but hey, we got them. Behind me, we have more clothing, more jerseys up there, a lot of local stuff, Rangers, Jets, Devils, Mets, Yankees. More graphic tees along the bottom two racks, and then some more winter stuff up here. So, like I said, we got something for everyone. Also in the front right here, we have some event used WWE chairs right here from, you know, like SummerSlam, WrestleMania, Battleground, 25 years of Raw, stuff like that. We have more slat wall over here with some socks and more wrestlers, DVDs, souvenirs. You got some trucks and whatnot. And then behind you, we have like a little bit of an oddball section. So right here, we have some bootleg Louis, Fendi. Bootleg's really big in the vintage game right now. Like I said, we focus mostly on cars, but we try to have something for everyone. And we have some, I don't know, some really cool like glasses up here. I mean, you can't really go wrong with a Bugs Bunny, Looney Tunes mug. Some cool stuff, some Adidas, Nike, Polo, Ralph, all that nice stuff right over here. All right, so like I said, we have a bunch of new displays. We got this little guy. It's full of mini microaggression WWE rumblers, some basketball pins, belt buckles, all different kinds of stuff. And then behind me, we loaded up on starting lineups and McFarland's and stuff like that, all the way up to the top. We got the 12 inches, three packs. Two-pack starting lineups. A lot of local guys, a lot of just Hall of Famers. So a lot of people collected these as a kid. They're not worth what they used to be, or not really worth that much at all. But, you know, for $5-$10 a pop, you can get Nolan Ryan, Mickey Mantle, guys like that, Cal Ripken, Griffey. Just a lot of cool stuff. One thing we didn't really change was the wrestling section. So we still have the wrestlers in the showcase. We have the sealed Hasbros, some sealed LJNs, a lot of Lucy's. This showcase is beautiful. So like I said, we didn't really change this section, but one thing we did do is put open boxes of cards up top. So like every pack here is $1 a piece. I think it gives it a nice little look to it. And then to the left of me, so these are the two newest things in the store. We got one display and then another display on the other side. So this side of the display, like they're double-sided, has glass shelves. So we got belts, we have wrestling figures, we have more belts, some other just random stuff, collectible balls, other figures and whatnot. So wrestling here, this is where we have a lot of our Jax classics, so some ringside exclusive stuff. This is a Montreal Screwjob right here with HBK and Bret Hart. Jax classics are really heating up in value, so we've been starting to pick them up and just load up on them because they sell. Wrestling stuff doesn't move like the, you know, like the cards or anything. But, I mean, I love wrestling. A lot of people love wrestling. So another thing that hasn't really changed, so we'll just go over it real quick, is the two shelves of, like, some higher-end wrestling stuff, some LJNs, the Black Series. You got the Hulk Hogan, Bossman with the original Nightstick, Ultimate Warrior. A lot of other oddball stuff, the Wrestling Buddies, which people still love. I did add this since the last video, a nice Wolverine store display figure. Got Ultimate Warrior mask. This was a gift from ECCK cards on Instagram. A lot of other cool stuff over here. That Space Jam display, totally forgot about that. And yeah, of course we have our merch right up here. If you ever come in, feel free to grab stickers, business cards. We sell the shot glasses, Fireball Fridays, every Friday. We've taken a break the last 2 weeks, but we still have them. Santiago sports pens are free, but the shot glasses are $5, keychains are $2. So yeah, and we also have our little, this is our Christmas tree at the time, but whatever. And we have another little section of like mini figures right here. And then as I come out, this is obviously new right here. We switched a lot of stuff around, so now we're gonna be getting into the cards. This showcase here is a mix of basketball, football, baseball, each row is a different sport. We've also been buying some Fortnite and Travis Scott stuff because I happen to fuck with Travis Scott and I think he's awesome. That's who I would love to be like one day. The guy's collabing with everyone. So this case full of cards. We got baseball, basketball, football on the bottom. And then this is probably the last section for toys. There's a lot more wrestling over here. We have the Mattel Retros, some more Jax Classics, some other odds and ends, some sealed belts. Up top, as you can see, some nice cool display stuff. Alright, so we have two showcases of cards as well. This one's mostly local teams, so Jets, Giants, Yankees, Eagles, stuff like that. Another mix of just, you know, things from $5 to like $100 or so. A lot of deals to be had in there. And then behind me, still have shelves full of wrestling, some other odds and ends, Star Wars, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, even though we're missing two of them, but whatever. And then this one, this showcase was over there originally. So we moved it over here, have some vintage in here and some other football, baseball, basketball, you know, lower end, not lower end, some mid-end stuff. And then we have a complete 2003 Topps 04 Chrome set right there. It's complete, and I have the OG box. So I thought that was pretty cool to put on display, even though I don't really care if I sell it or not. And I just had to get the prism out of the way, so prism there. All right, so the middle of the store, two of the biggest new attractions we have here. I added some displays, obviously. A couple of these bad boys are like these shelving cubby units. This one in particular is stacked with dollar cards and then some 10 cent cards in the bottom. So pretty much anything over here is a deal to be had. We have a little supply section. Supplies are hard to get, but we got top loaders, mags, card savers, sleeves right next to me. We keep PSA bags on deck, team bags, all that good stuff. Nice little pennant section if you want some displays. So right in the middle of the store, you got where the two displays come together. So you got so much stuff to look at. To the right, you have McFarlane's, shelves of Funkos. This is all hockey over here and basketball. Bunch of different, McFarlane's, like Tom Brady, Montana, Derek Jeter, Cal Ripken. And then we also have bargain boxes on bargain boxes. So what I like to do with my bargain boxes is, so if you're into cards, you know that the market's changing all the time. Pricing every card is almost useless at this point. Cards are changing so much that I'm not pricing the stuff that's going out in these boxes. The way I do it is, if you like a card, if you like a bunch of cards, you bring it up to me. Most of them I know the price for, but most of them I'll comp out, and I'm gonna try to give you a deal on it. I think that's the easiest and fairest way to do it, because I'm all for people getting a deal, but when you're finding, sometimes, like I've seen it happen before, you're finding a $200 card for like $3 in a box, makes the guy selling the card feel like kind of like crap. So I like to try and be fair with people. I'll definitely, you know, work with people, but one thing that I don't like is when people just expect a deal right away. I like talking, I like, you know, getting to know you a little bit, but can't always expect a deal. So like I said, all bargain boxes, baseball, football, basketball, a little bit of hockey, a little bit of soccer, some vintage over here, a lot of 77 Tops. More 10 cent cards. We even have some vintage magazines right here, some Sports Illustrated, more McFarland, some more just oddball kind of stuff. So yeah, all the hats are pretty dope too. I mean, like, who doesn't want to wear that? I was never a big South Park guy, but that's a nice hat. Stanley Cup embroidered and everything. USA, big win the other day for hockey. A lot of other dope stuff over here, but we're gonna move on to the other side of this because I think it's even cooler. So this is the other side of the middle. So this one has a lot of bobbleheads up there, some really hard to find forever collectibles. Fun fact, I love bobbleheads. I think they're awesome. My room's decked out with them. This is a local section over here with figures and whatnot. So a lot of Yankees, Mantle, Henderson, A-Rod, Jose Reyes, guys like that. Baseball hats and some other miscellaneous soccer. So vintage snapbacks on deck. Shouldn't have won that Super Bowl. Fuck the Giants. More merch. Fireball Friday. Or if you're a Justin Bieber fan, like Frank the Tank wants this shirt, but I told him I can't sell it to him. So shout out to Frank the Tank. Good kid. Kind of a Sugats, but you know what I mean. And then, I don't know if you guys remember, we caught this in the flea market vlog. So go check that vlog out, by the way. You guys seem to like the sports cards vlogs and all that stuff more, but shit, those are pretty fucking lit too. Fry guy, you got the adult video guy, we got Dave who runs Kids Over, all stuff like that. But this thing's dope. But the part that people want to see the most, the wax wall. So
So we added a whole new wax wall. We're talking 12 feet of shelving that way, and then more 12 feet on top. So we're talking 24 feet of wax and some other like jumbo helmets, mini helmets and whatnot. Some more sicko mode Travis Scott stuff.
So we didn't only just add this wax wall. So this wax wall over here is mostly retail, a little bit of hobby. People don't understand that I don't pay people to go sit at fucking line on Walmart and Target. I don't do that. It's hard for me to get product too. Like, I just want people to understand. People are like, oh, this is why Walmart's empty. No, I'm not why fucking Walmart's empty. There's people that come to me who, you know, do sit at these Walmarts and Targets and sell this shit to me. I'm not paying retail pricing. I'm paying sometimes double retail, or I'm paying $10 over retail and stuff like that. So I'm paying resale prices too, and then I'm also selling them again. So I'm not getting stuff for retail. I just want people to understand that. A lot of people like to think that I do. I do not. I wish that was the case. Everyone wishes that was the case, but the game has changed. I don't know what to tell you guys. In the last year, the game has fucking changed. And if you can't adapt to that, then hey, so be it. Maybe it's not for you. Something I feel like I have to say. But on top of the wax wall, we go from baseball, football, hockey, basketball, football. Everything sells. And then underneath, we added cellos. So we got a whole wall of cello packs. So anything from like $5 to $10 a pack to like a $200 mega box. I mean, we have a nice variety. I like to think that we do have a very nice variety compared to other stores in the area, even the state. It's hard to get stuff, and I try to buy everything I can to make sure people come and can find what they're looking for. Even over here, like I said, two more brand new showcases full of singles, and then this bottom one's actually full of wax. So some interesting stuff in here. We got 2013 Heritage, 2005 Bowman Chrome Football, Aaron Rodgers, the fucking deal. I told you guys, if you watched the Aaron Rodgers PC showcase, I told you guys he's next up, and look at him now, fucking exploded. Should have listened. More stuff in here, a lot of slabs, basketball slabs, prism and whatnot, some more older wax on the counter. We have a nice little wrestling pack section, anything from like $1 to like $5 a pack. This is a basketball showcase. So we got a nice little Kobe Lakers section, a lot of autos and relics, prism rookies and whatnot. So these two showcases are the ones that haven't moved. The only thing they've moved is up about 1 foot, so I have more space. Last video too, we had only had a table back here. Now, if Jason puts the camera up a little bit, you'll see we have cabinets full of wax and whatnot. And all the singles and stuff. We got our cases back here. This is also a new addition. We moved it right here. So we got pretty much a rack pack. So everything here is packed out. Everything's like $1 to $5. So we usually don't really sell stuff in pack form because moving the boxes is so easy. But we do have a small selection of packs that you could buy. Like I said, it's just easier to move stuff in a box, in box form. And it's usually not fair to sell packs now because you get people that just open it to pull the hits. And when there's no hits left, you're left with the other stuff. And you have people asking you constantly, oh, what was pulled, stuff like that. So I personally don't think it's fair for people, once like a hit is pulled, to be like, oh, is it there? Is it, you know, stuff like that. I don't like that, so I try not to, you know, do that to people. I hate being asked that, and I hate asking people that. I just feel like I don't like that at all. But we do have packs, Bowman drafts right there, and then behind me, this is the baseball wax wall. So this is pretty much all hobby baseball, update tops, some higher end products, National Treasures. Of course, we still have our TV, and I don't know why we're watching it either, but whatever. Jumbo logo. This is a baseball case. Like I said, we try to keep it separated. So baseball case, and then moving on over. This is my seat. Ah, I love this seat. I bought this seat at a Quaker Steak and Lube that went out of business for like $15. That was a steal. Got two of them. So this wall is full of football and basketball. Mostly hobby, a little bit of retail. Like I said, it's hard to get product like that. Also some Fortnite. We got some Upper Deck Golf up there if you're looking for Tiger Woods. And this showcase in particular is all football, a little bit of soccer. Like I said, we try to dabble in that a little bit. Not really any Pokemon yet. There is some Pokemon in here. those ETB boxes and booster boxes and stuff like that. So we do Pokemon just a little bit. I'm personally not into the Pokemon, but I try to have something for everyone. But I mean, that's pretty much it. The shop has changed a lot in the last, 3 months we did the video, Jay? Something like that, yeah?
Yep.
So the video that we're doing right now is going to look way different than the one before. And I really hope you guys enjoy it, because we changed this thing around for you guys. I would love to have a bigger store, but we're doing just fine the way we are right now. So I really appreciate everybody that comes in, likes our videos on YouTube, follows our Santiago Sports Instagram page, follows us on TikTok, Twitter, eBay, even though we're not on eBay that much. But I really appreciate all the support, and I hope you guys can show some love to this video and on our Instagram account and stuff like that. So let's fucking go. 2021 is going to be an absolute movie. Dallas is coming up soon. It's going to be a monster fucking year. Just wait for it. Make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe, support, all that stuff. Santiago Sports 2021 to the fucking moon. You can get rid of who? Me and Tay slide on niggas, and we got missus too. I'm off at Eddie, I'm up. I don't got no time to relax.
I fucking hate Tyler. Been over here.